seminar, where we have the pleasure of having with us Jacques de Fourny and Marthe Nissens. They will be talking with us about a research project that they have been coordinating for several years now. The title of their presentation is Mapping and Testing Social Enterprise Models Across the World, A Travel Across the International Comparative Social Enterprise Models, ICSEM Project. So without further delay, I will pass the floor on to Jacques.
Hello, everybody. Please travel with us through the various stages of the ICSEM project, which is an amazing international research project that we will present in several points, especially our efforts to provide this project with a theory-based analytical framework and a methodology which is quite specific. So, we first have to observe that since the early 90s, there have been dozens or maybe hundreds of attempts to define social enterprise by putting emphasis on one or two distinctive features. For example, the profile of individual social entrepreneurs, or the place of social innovation, or the search for market income in nonprofit organizations. In front of these incredible diversity, some authors try to build at least typologies, classification in face of such a large diversity of social enterprise observed on the ground. And for instance, the US scholars Gregory Dees propose a spectrum going from a purely philanthropic pole to a purely commercial pole, saying that most social enterprises are between these two poles. Various other attempts were made, but most of them provided useful lenses to grasp such diversity, but mostly inductive, and they were country specific. So we took as a challenge to go one step further by providing strong theoretical foundation to explain how various institutional logics in the whole economy may generate different social enterprise models. For this, we will rely on the concept of principle of interest, which will be a very cornerstone of the construction that I will present now. If we look at the entire economy, it's quite conventional to say that the major place is taken by capital interest for profit firms. So they occupy one of the angle in the lower side of the picture. The state is supposed to pursue the general interest, the overall interest of the community, and sometimes it delegates some mission of general interest to association, which in countries like ours are very numerous and have a major role in the socio-economic landscape. And sometimes a third principle of interest is forgotten. It's the mutual interest, which may be observed in organizations where the member look for their own interest by organizing themselves the production of service or goods and in an organization that they are managing themselves. So it's the common interest of a close group. For example, cooperative historically and association like professional association are typically mutual interest organization. In this overall framework, our idea was to identify first and locate some trajectories which may transform the existing organization into more entrepreneurial stances. For example, general interest associations increasingly are lacking some resources because there is too much competition on the fundraising field, for example. And so joint interest may go a bit downward marketing, to raise more market income and make their financing mix more hybrid. So they still seek the general interest, but with a greater attention to generate marketing income. Now, looking at the other lower interest, the neutral interest, we witness the fact that cooperatives increasingly develop activities which are not just for the sake of members, but to deal with more general, more interest issue. And for example, in many countries, among which Italy, many cooperatives have become or have been created as social cooperatives. Cooperatives not only looking to members, but also to the overall community. And it's the same for some type of association who combine member interest with some broader social concern. In the angle of for-profit organization, you see that for-profit firms are driven clearly by capital interest, but some, and they also move upward to include in their objective some social concern or social objective as well. Sometimes it's just greenwashing or corporate social responsibility at a very artificial and limited extent, but sometimes they go as far as needed to set up social business, social enterprise, in which the for-profit keeps the control, but develop activities which are well beyond their pure financial and economic interest. SMEs may do the same, for example, a fair trade shop, which at the same time seek revenue for the people setting the shop, but as well some concern for the community at large with fair trade goods. And finally, the state may also be seen as a social enterprise model because the state as well needs some more market resources in many fields. For example, in work integration social enterprise, you may find at the outset state initiative, municipalities, province, who alone or with other municipalities set up work integration quasi-public social enterprise. On that basis, I can conclude this part by saying that there are two moves from existing organizations. Those in the lower part of the triangle are looking towards more orientation to general interest, and so they include this in their overall objective. An organization already taking care of the general interest, like the state and GI association, try to get a bit more market resources in order to increase their financial means. Now I pass the floor to my colleague, Mark Nissens.
Let's follow this XM travel. So as you know, this XM project was quite huge. There were research involved from more than 60 countries. What's very important to understand in the XM project is that no a priori strict definition of social enterprise was given or imposed. So we just delineated the field of analysis as made of organization that combine entrepreneurial dynamics to provide goods and services with the primacy of social aims. There were two important phases. In the first phase, all research provided a kind of country contribution. They were asked to answer the following type of question: to what extent the notion of social enterprise makes sense in your national context, in which field these SE are involved, which are the legal forms of this SE, what are their social mission, and so on. To capture the diversity of this field, the notion of models was proposed, but in a very broad sense, without giving any a priori typology. In a second phase, this time, in order to test the relevance of our theory-based typology of SE models, we rely on the data collected to a very large quantitative survey. For that purpose, the MS idle type was used as a kind of methodological tool to inform the diversity. As you probably know, this idle type is based on three dimensions: the nature of the social mission, the type of economic model, and the type of governance structure. So the decision to ask to collect information about this major dimension does not mean that each organization has to adopt a set of very strict conditions in order to qualify it as a social enterprise. It only means that it's relevant to collect information regarding the dimension that should help each research locate the position of the observed social enterprise in relation to the one other and to the pole star. So, what is the goal at this stage? It is to test, based on this data, at the enterprise level, the relevance of our typology of SE models. You see on this slide the type of the sample. In fact, each local research collected 3 to 5 social enterprises emblematic of each SE type identified by themselves in the first phase of the project. It's very important to understand that this sample is by no way representative of this SE population, as this population is just unknown. So, to reach the result, we performed multiple factorial analysis followed by clustering analysis. We decided to keep 7 clusters. You see these 7 clusters on this slide. Impossible to go into the details. I invite you to read the paper to have a good idea of to characterize each of these clusters. But what's important at this stage to remember? First, one cluster is indicating the existence of a social business model. That's the first column. 2 clusters are very close to the social cooperative model. 1 in the field of microfinance. The other one does gather a lot of different social missions. And finally, 4 clusters are converging towards an entrepreneurial non-profit SE model. So, the main conclusion is that 3 among our 4 models find very strong empirical support. Indeed, these models are found in 39 countries out of the 43 countries of the sample. It's true that a topology doesn't include a kind of semi-public SE model. Indeed, it's impossible to identify this model to a distinct cluster. However, in the WISE clusters, in cluster 4 and cluster 5, around 10% of the SE involve a kind of public agency among their founding members. Finally, in contrast to the view highlighting SE as a kind of market solution to a social problem, it's quite interesting to see that half of the SE in the survey display very broad financial structure. This is the case in cluster 5, 6, and 7. Our data sets also allow to perform the same kind of statistical analysis for three regional SE subsamples for Latin America, Western Europe, and Central and Eastern Europe. We see that within each of these regions, the SE patterns prove to be very similar to those emerging at the global level. All three SE models can be identified at this regional level. Of course, we see some regional specificity. I have no time to go into details, so I invite you to go to the Routledge books, which will be published in the coming month. The main lesson which has to be learned from this exercise is that our SE model typology is neither country-specific nor even more broadly context-specific. Of course, we need to go more deeply in SE ecosystem, which deserve further research. Jacques, you can follow the travel.
To conclude this presentation, let us look at policy implication of these results. In short, the diversity and the local embeddedness of SE models call at the same time for avoiding several traps or risks. First, there is a risk to focus exclusively on the most appealing social enterprise model while neglecting the potential of the other models. For example, international bodies like Ashoka try to identify and celebrate the outstanding profile of individual social entrepreneurs who indeed have great achievement. But the attention drawn by these success stories may weaken the attention to other models. Second, there is a risk to exploit social enterprise diversity, so to acknowledge the multiple character of social enterprise, while focusing only on narrow fields. For example, EU-funded programs in Central and Eastern European countries are mostly focusing on work integration of the disadvantaged or handicapped people and so on. And so only the field of work integration is really supported, and the other SE models for other fields are not exploited. Another risk is to forget that social enterprise models generally need distinct ecosystems. To emerge and to develop, social enterprise models have some time to be supported by new legal framework, because there is no legislation really adapted to some models. In countries like Taiwan, for example, there is a major law making the access to public procurement, public contract, quite easy for social enterprise. And so the ecosystem, in which has a lot of dimension, must be considered as critical for the development of social enterprise. Another risk is to ignore the whole spectrum of potential partnership among models. It's not really a trap, it's a potential which would not be enough exploited, because even through the triangle, we can locate on the side of the triangle intermediary position which can represent cooperation, partnership between incubators or several SE models, foundation involved in venture philanthropy, and so on. In that case, various types of partnership are available, and it would be a pity to avoid, to forget, to neglect the potential they represent. And finally, there might be also a risk to pay greater attention to SE models which are supported by big communication strategies. For example, Mohamed Yunus has launched a series of global social business summits which gathers mainly multinational corporations which say their willingness to support some SE experience. But sometimes the celebration, the size of the communication strategies are much greater than the actual realization on the field. And so it's important to look at this variation closely and cautiously. To really conclude now, I would like to draw the attention of the PhD students and early career professor I have in front of me or looking to us. I want to draw your attention to the fact that all these risks are major topics which could be dealt with by young researchers, early career professors. We shouldn't see these various risks or traps as a limitation. They call mainly for further knowledge and for gathering people to improve the ecosystem and the recognition of this great variety of social enterprise models. Thank you.
Thank you, and see you very soon.
Thank you very much to Jacques and Marthe, and we will see you all on October 24th, Saturday, to continue this presentation after Julia Galera's presentation as well. Thank you very much, and see you very soon.